Now somebody tag Whipple and tell him that your girl need a sponsorship ASAP. Y'all better make sure y'all stay tapped into this video because I'm gonna tell y'all about how you can go about getting your sponsorship. Your girl got her first one, got sponsored on them wheels right there. So we finna go through how did I do that, and I hope that you get some sponsorships too. And what I am gonna say to start off this video before we get into them qualifications is you are going to have to invest in yourself. Y'all, you cannot ask someone to invest in you if you have not invested in yourself. So I'm just gonna put that right there on the table before we get started. Let's get into it now. Y'all, so we done got the Jeep pulled over, but I still gotta wipe my wheels down, so I'm gonna get my supplies out the back. If y'all don't know, I shop at Jack's Wax, so I got all my goods. I'm trying to see if it's on this side. If you ain't riding around with a bucket of towels, I don't know what you're doing right now, but your girl got the towels. Grab this one. I just got these out the wash. Dryer. I got my Rapstar. This is detail spray for the vinyl, but you can also use it on the wheels. So I'm gonna go ahead and bust the wheels down real quick before we get into this video, because you know we gotta do a proper. And right now what I'm doing is I'm knocking the dust off of it. I'm not actually wiping really hard because I need to get washed up. So I'm gonna just knock the dust off of it so that it looks good in the video, and then we're gonna get to rolling. All right, y'all, so to knock the dust off of one wheel, I ain't gonna lie, your girl being lazy right now, but I did want to let y'all know that your girl has been officially sponsored by Ferrata, and that's really the reason why I'm rocking these wheels right now. Y'all saw me, and I'll drop a link to the video when I actually did the, when I bolted up on these. But super excited to be sponsored by them. Put my hat in the ring, and I'ma tell y'all about a few things that if you're looking to get a sponsorship, some of the things that you wanna do to your vehicle so that you can be the best contender to get a sponsorship. So whether that's partial, whether that's full, everything counts, because y'all already know it's expensive to mod our cars and our Jeeps, whatever you rocking with, it's expensive to mod it. So you wanna try to get as many people that want to put their product on your vehicle so that you can showcase that as you're going other places. So let's go ahead and get into it, and I'm gonna give y'all a close-up of the wheels, and we're just gonna have a little chat. All right, so the wheels that I was sponsored for are the CM1 graphite face with a black lip finish. We were actually going to do a different set on the Jeep, but I'm really happy about how these came out. I'm trying to think. I think I was gonna do full black, so all black. If you have been rocking with my channel, then you know that I was on Belgians previously. The Belgians were, they had like a graphite finish as well, but a little bit of a different finish than these do. So I do like that I stuck with that because it does make it pop a lot more. The Ferrata center cap is red. I wanted to change that out to blue, but they said, girl, you're doing too much. So we gonna rock with that, and I'll probably eventually get these powder coated so that they can match the Jeep a little bit better. But I'm not mad at it because right now my Brembos are red, so it kind of ties everything together. So these are the wheels itself. Really like how they look on the Jeep. So now I know y'all talking about, Kendra, you done already talked about these wheels. We want to know how you done got sponsored. Let us know the tea, y'all. So If y'all remember Wham, so I dropped the video for Wham. Right before that, I bolted up on these Ferrata wheels. Ferrata was doing, right around that time, a Instagram call out for, if you want to be sponsors, send us over some pictures of your whip. It had to meet a certain number of qualifications for it to be qualified to be able to be sponsored. So I'm gonna get into what those qualifications were, because those are things, and I think it's a formula to how other people are looking at who they sponsor or who they don't sponsor, as they're trying to put their product out on the street. All right, so the first thing that you need to have is you need to be able to stand out. The one thing I love about this wrap is it's, even though it is blue, it's still subtle enough for me to feel comfortable driving wherever I want to, yet it is distinct enough for people to know that when they see this blue that I'm pulling up. And I feel like that is very important when you are trying to get a sponsorship. So how are you standing out from the crowd? The next thing, it, y'all, and I'm being so serious, is air suspension. Now that's definitely an investment. I ain't gonna lie, that's an investment. But most manufacturers of something, they want to put their product on whatever the latest is. And so especially for the Jeep, having this air suspension helps set me apart from other Jeeps, because if you look at other Jeeps, there are some that have air suspension, but many do not. And I promise, I love a Jeep on air suspension. And it's a difference from, you know, having springs or coils and air suspension, and I'll go through a whole different video on that. But the stance is different. You get so much more variety with what you want to do. I could actually have it all the way aired up in the front and all the way aired at the back, just to be crazy if I wanted to. The next thing that you're going to want to have, and I ain't going to lie, I don't know how I snuck in the back door on this one, but you want to have a large following. Now granted, I am still trying to build my following on Instagram, which is where probably majority of folks want you to have the largest platform. I think it's fair for like YouTube and TikTok and like all these other platforms, but I think Instagram is the main source that folks are still judging things on. And so you want to be able to have a strong following to where the people that are seeing your vehicle are the same people that is their target audience. So, you know, you want to put your product in front of your target audience without even saying anything. So by somebody dropping a picture, by me dropping a picture with the Ferrata wheels, their target audience is automatically seeing that, because they want people that are in the community, the car community, because that's who they service. So that is another big thing with getting sponsorship. And I think that really tells the difference between folks that get partial sponsorships versus full sponsorships. You know, it might have a little bit more of a following with that, but like I said, any kind of sponsorship is a good one, because stuff is very expensive. Now for the Chargers and Challengers, what I know is that you better have a wide body, okay? That wide body is gonna set you apart. I don't know too many vendors or manufacturers that are really giving out sponsorships to slim bodies. There might be a few of them, but like I said, having that new thing on the block, that sets you apart. So if you look at some folks that have these sponsorships, they got new cars, they got, you know, all this stuff. So making sure that you are, one, setting yourself apart, you know, two, growing your page. How are you growing your page, y'all? Y'all don't sleep on the power of these decals. I promise y'all, I done got so many followers on Instagram and all kind of platforms, because people know where to find me at. You see a blue Jeep, you like, dang, that I want to follow that blue Jeep. You know exactly where to go to. I've gotten people that said, man, them decals, once I put them on there, I got so many tags that I wasn't getting. Y'all, people take all these pictures of your vehicle. If they don't know who to tag, then you missing out on all that love. So don't sleep on the power of these decals. But I wasn't gonna make this video too long. I just wanted to really share my excitement about being sponsored by Ferrata. I love the wheels. I'm going to probably do something a little bit different so I get a better fitment on them. So I'm gonna start looking at my tires. Once I get my accent color figured out, there might be some powder coating in the future. I'm not sure yet, so y'all gonna have to stay tuned. We got some folks pulling up here at the shop. It is almost Christmas. I cannot believe it, but I'm hoping to drop one more video before Christmas. But if I don't, I do wish everybody a happy holiday, wishing everybody blessings and love and peace and enjoying time with your family. And I will holler at y'all soon. I always appreciate the love. Until next time, peace. Oh my goodness, y'all, I almost forgot another key thing. Y'all, you gotta make sure you a positive influence, y'all. If somebody is putting their brand on your vehicle, they want to make sure that the content that you are putting out is consistent with the brand that they're building. Let that sink in. The content that you're putting out is consistent with the brand that they're building, y'all. That is so important. So you got to think about, what's your lane? Where are you trying to go? How does that fit in? And then you go from there on, you know, applying, putting your hat out there, and letting these folks see who you are without you even having to talk. So let this picture speak for themselves. And that's what I like to do, is I drop a picture and let it speak for itself. That's all I do, and I appreciate it kind of paying off. Somebody leaving the shop right there, but I just had to get back on here before I let y'all go. Y'all gotta let that sink in though. But I'm gonna holler at y'all next time.